This hollow cylinder. So this one is hollow cylinder. This one is hollow cylinder. Hollow cylinder. This the internal radius small r. External radius denoted by capital R. This one is height. Height or length equal to h. Thickness. This one is thickness. Thickness W. This sir, third sir, thickness W equal to 4 cm given, external radius are given 16 cm, length or height equal to 13 cm, these particulars are given, therefore internal we find the internal radius small r equal to capital R minus W, this one is hollow, internal radius small r. Capital radius, external radius capital R. This one is the thickness. Thickness equal to W. Thickness equal to W. W equal to capital R minus small r. This formula. Substitute here. Capital R equal to 16 minus W equal to 4. 16 minus 4 equal to 12 centimeter. We find the small r radius. Internal radius finding. Internal radius R equal to 12 cm. Total surface area of a hollow cylinder. Total surface area of a hollow cylinder formula 2 pi capital R, 2 pi into capital R plus small r into capital R minus small r plus h. Once again, 2 pi into capital R plus small r into capital R minus small r plus h. This one is total surface area of a hollow cylinder. So substitute here, 2 into the value of y 22 by 7, capital R 16, small r 12, into 16 minus 12 plus 13. Simplify 2 into 22 by 7, add these two numbers 28, 16 minus 12, 4, 4 plus 13, 17. 17 is denominator. Denominator and numerator both sides divided by 17 upon 177, 4 sevens are 28. 222 are 44, 4 into 17, 68. Multiply these two numbers, 68 into 44 equal to 2992. The unit is very, very important. Area, square, unit, volume, cubic unit. Therefore, total surface area of your hollow cylinder, 2992 square centimeter. Next, core. This one is the shape of a cone. Height, this one is height, this one is slant height, this one is radius. The lot of formulas having the cone, radius r equal to square root of l squared minus h squared, height h equal to square root of l squared minus r squared, slant height l equal to square root of h squared plus r squared. Next. Curved surface area of a cone equal to pi r l. Total surface area of a cone equal to pi r into l plus r. Volume of a cone equal to 1 by 3 pi r squared h. These six formulas are very, very important. Next, fourth, sir. In a right angle triangle, Q 90 degree. QR, the side length of QR equal to 16, PR equal to 20 are given. So this side we don't know. Apply the Pythagoras theorem here. Next chapter, last chapter, geometry. At that time you deeply studied the Pythagoras theorem. So apply it here. PQ squared equal to PR squared minus QR squared. This one is the Pythagoras theorem. So this very, very important theorem, Pythagoras theorem, last chapter, sixth chapter, geometry very deeply at that time. PR 20 squared minus 16 squared. 20 multiplied by 2 times 20 into 20 400. 16 16s are 256. 16 multiplied by 2 times 256, 400 minus 256 equal to 144. PQ PQ square equal to 144. PQ equal to square root of 144. The square root value of 144. 10 times are 100. 11 times are 121. 12 times are 142. So PQ equal to at least 30 table in your finger. PQ equal to 12 centimeter. Then PQ side is rotated. This side PQ is rotated at the time. Imagine this one cone. This one is a cone. PQ is rotated at the time. This one is slant height. Slant height L equal to 20. This one is radius 12 centimeter. Defined 12 centimeter. The curved surface area of your cone equal to pi r l. So pi substitute not necessary to substitute the value 22 by 7. So pi into radius 12 into L 20. Two 12s are 24 and 10 pi square centimeter. This pi is very very important. So right here. Next, when QR is rotated means this one is QR here. So this one is the cone. This one is imaginary. QR equal to this one is radius. Slant head. So radius r equal to 16. Slant head l equal to 20. Curved surface area of your cone equal to pi r l. Pi here r radius 16 l 20. 320 pi square centimeter. So compare, ask the question. Curved surface area of your cone when rotated, QR is larger. Compare this, 320 is larger. So you write here, this step. Curved surface area of your cone when rotated, QR is larger. This one is the answer. Next, fifth question. Slab height is given, 19 centimeter. Floor area, each person 22 square meter. Therefore, 4 persons are living in the tent. So, floor area of 4 person equal to 4 into 22, 88 square meter. The, in the cone, the bottom of the side is in the shape of a circle. The area of a circle equal to formula pi r squared. Area of a circle formula pi r squared equal to 2 pi r squared is in the same circle. So on that area of a circle pi r squared equal to 88, pi 22 by 7 into r squared equal to 88, r squared equal to 88 into 7 by 22. So both the numerator and the denominator divided by 11 times 2, 11 are 22, 8 11 are 88. Again, 2 table. 1, 2 is 2, 4, 2 are 8. 4, 7 are 28, r squared equal to 28. Not necessary to find the square root. Therefore, height h equal to formula. Already we know the formula. Height h equal to square root of l squared minus r squared. Substitute here, l equal to 19 squared minus r squared value 28. 19 multiplied by 2 times, 19 is 361 minus 28. So subtract here 333. Carefully you find the square root. So pair of digits are here. Give it. This one is 3. 1 is 1. 3 minus 1 2. 2 decimal. Now here 33. So multiply it 2. The side level other 2 on a particular. The number of the 2 on a particular. 1 2 is 2. So how many times? 23 divided by 2, maximum 8 times. Put it here. 8 are 64, divided by 6, 8 2s are 16, 22, subtract 9. So multiplied by 2 times, 2 8s are 16, remainder 1, 1 plus 2, 3. So add 2 0 here. So 9 divided by 3, maximum 2 times. 2, put it here. 2 2s are 2, 2s are 4, 2 6s are 1, remaining 1, 2 3s are 6, 7, and get subtract. And goes on. So 18.24 goes on. So you write the answer 18.25 meter. Therefore, height of the tent is height of the tent is 18.25 meter. Okay, all of you understand it?